Hello everyone. In this online video lecture series of Theory of Dying, today in this video we will discuss about dyeing of wool and silk with basic dyes as continuation of topic basic dyes of textile materials. As you know, wool and silk have carboxylic group in its structure, and due to presence of carboxylic group in wool and silk polymers, and basic dyes have affinity for protein fiber. In this dye cation react with this COOH sites to form electrovalent bond between dyes and fiber, and so we can say by the electrovalent bond type of dye fiber attractions, basic dyes will remain in protein fibers. So here you can see in the very symmetric chemical representations of fiber, that is NH2 group, W is represent the wool fiber, and COOH group. These two are reactive groups, and this is the rest of the wool fiber. Here there is a basic dye R4N+, that is a dication which is have color, that is small anion. So when wool is entered in the water, it is ionized. If it is ionized in the CO-, the H will be go this side, and the R4N+ Cl-. So at this side at COOH site, the dication is attached, and HCl is liberated. So this liberated HCl will retard the reactions. So we can say that HCl retard the faster reaction and facilitate the labeling of the shed. When protein fibers are dyed with the wool, or when the proteins fiber like wool and silk dyed with the basic dye, they possess good washing fastness but poor light fastness. Exception is acrylic in case of acrylic, which is invariably dyed with the basic dye to develop the brilliant shade with excellent washing fastness due to higher binding force at polyacrylonitrile, that is the monomer of the acrylic with basic dye junctions, than protein fiber basic dye junction. So here we can say the protein fiber basic dye junction, that is formation of the electrovalent bond with the fiber and dye, is not so strong enough as comparative to the polyacrylonitrile, that is acrylic basic dyeing junction. That's why the fastness property of the basic dyed acrylic material is comparatively more better, or we can say excellent, to protein fiber dyed with basic dye. So protein fiber can be dyed with the basic dye, and we can represent it in this fashion. Now we will discuss about the fastness property of the basic dyed material. As you know that the acrylic fibers are generally dyed with the basic dye, here you can see that the fastness property of the cationic dye so excellent with acrylic in case of protein or in case of cellulose after modanting, the fastness property of the basic dyes are not as good as in case of the acrylic. Why this is? As we discussed here just now about that, the higher binding force at dye fiber junction in case of a acrylic or basic dye junction, that's why the removal of the dye during the washing is not easy comparative to the other dye fiber interaction. Second reason is in case of acrylic dyeing, the better trapping of the dye molecule inside the fiber structure due to dyeing above its glass transition temp temperature and its compact structure. As you know, acrylic is a man-made fiber and have some thermosetting properties. So when we dye the acrylic at a high temperature, or we can say above the glass transition temperature, that is 80-85 degree centigrade, and above that temperature, the opening of the fiber structure happened, and due to opening of the fiber structure, dye molecule penetrated inside the fiber structure, and when after dyeing, we cool down the dye bath, and by cool down the dye bath, the fiber structure is collapsed, and the dye particles which are inside the fiber structure is trapped. That's why the washing fastness after trapping these dye molecules are not easily come out from the fiber. That's why we can say the washing fastness of the acrylic fiber dyed with cationic dye is much better than the other fibers like protein fiber dyed with the basic dyes. So now, second, the incident light on basic dyes when applied on protein fiber is not transmitted to the fiber, causing degradation of dye. That's why the light fastness of the fabric is inferior, or can say light fastness of the fabric is degraded. But in case of polyacryl or nitrile fiber, that is acrylic fiber, the incident light is absorbed. That's why the light fastness is not hampered, or we can say light fastness is not affected negatively. Second, protein fiber retain the moisture, that is water, which on reaction with atmospheric oxygen produce hydrogen peroxide, and this is in turns oxidized dye. So this, the hydrogen peroxide produces will oxidize the dye. That means the color, the loss of the color. That's why also the light fastness of the protein fiber dyed with the basic dye is affected negatively. But this is not happened with the in case of acrylic, that is polyacryl or nitrile chemical paste. So because it did not absorb moisture, that's why the formation of the hydrogen peroxide is not associated with this. Second, introduction of in case of acrylic fiber, the dye fiber junction is more strong, because in acrylic fiber we introduce anionic copolymers, which makes polyacryl nitride highly anionic, and development of dye parallelly development of dye molecule by imparting quaternary ammonium group at one end of the dye chain rather than NH3 plus at the center, it leads the better fastness property, because there is more in terms of magnitude, there is more anionic fiber is more anionic in nature, or simultaneously dye is also more cationic in nature. That's why more anionic, more cationic charge. So there is the strength of the electrovalent bond between the dye and the fiber, that is acrylic, is more stronger comparative to the wool or silk type of protein fiber interaction with the basic dyes. Next, light fastness and chemical constitutions of dyes are closely related, and the lesser the basicity of the dye, the better the light fastness, and the more the dye fiber bond is, the more the dye fiber bond is of electrostatic nature, the lower the light fastness. So as we just discussed about, in case of acrylic fiber dyeing with basic dye, there is a electrostatic bond is much stronger. But as here we can say the more the dye fiber bond is of electrostatic nature, it lowers the light fastness. Also, basicity of the dye. If the lesser basicity of the dye, then the light fastness will be the better. So in case of acrylic fiber dyeing with basic dye, these both things will impact negatively on the light fastness, but also increase in homopolarity, decrease light fastness. But in special cationic dyes, the cation is far away from the rest part of the dye, fulfilling all these requirements. So in the especially synthesized cationic dyes for acrylic fiber, the cation is far away from the rest part of the dye molecule. That's why by doing this, these two things can be avoided. Thank you very much. In this video, we have discussed about the basic dyeing of the protein fibers and overall fastness property of the basic dye material, that may be protein fiber, that may be acrylonitrile, polyacrylonitrile, that is acrylic fiber. So thank you very much. We will discuss dyeing of acrylic fiber in the next video of this online video lecture series. Thank you.